Okay. So, what is the session about? What we're trying to do here is come to you as a community and show you certain things that we felt were quite missing within the European spectrum in particular, and also come up with a specific suggestion of how we think we can cover those things as a community and make this community stronger. This effort, we call it the European Council on Computing Infrastructure. This is what we're going to cover: backgrounds, purpose, proposed structure, and discuss more about how we think this will going to work in the long term, and discuss the next steps ahead, and then open it up for discussion so we can hear your feedback. After this meeting, Rafael will circulate questionnaire to ask for feedback from those who didn't have enough time to provide it here, and then we'll process these results together and see how we can move forward based on that. So, let's get on. Motivation. Europe has many strong worldwide players in the field of computing research for this industry. Yet Europe is less known as an international hub for construction computing research when compared to other continents, such as North America and recently Asia. Part of the reason for that is organizational. Europe lacks an internationally recognized community structure that other continents enjoy in this field of research. Hence, our events tend to be a little bit more inwards focused and less known to the rest of the planet and poorly attended by the international community. In essence, Europe, in my view, needs something equivalent to organize societies like, for example, ASE's computing division. What I'm talking about here is a European-wide thought leader that's academic-led, research-focused, able to not just have an annual conference where we meet every year, we do quite a lot of those, but actually be able to produce position or policy papers, grant challenge reports, and so on, that can give it international recognition. We have these kinds of groups at a very local level, for example, in the UK, in Germany, and in other European countries. But like I said, these are naturally inwards looking communities that do not enjoy the same level of international recognition that others do. There's also some groups at the European level, but they do not meet all of these criteria, and hence, for the same reason, lack that level of information. I did a little bit of research in this, and please bear in mind it's not exhaustive, and I'm sure there are more examples, but I think it's quite indicative of what's happening. First of all, I started looking at related European associations. Do we have European associations that can help us achieve these kinds of targets? Well, first I looked at what I call groups of groups, like CREDI, ECF, and ECHO. These are all coordination-type societies that are there to coordinate other communities. Very interesting concept, but what they all have in common is extremely low to non-existent activity. Effectively, what happened is that these associations were set up at some point in time. There was a lot of enthusiasm, but as the years passed, they were not able to create a sustainable structure that would sustain those communities live and growing over time. Another category of organizations are those that are research-oriented. We have, for example, some well-known communities like ECTP, like EAPPM, EGAIS, and others, and so on. What's common about them is that they are a lot more active. They have significant membership, they do quite a lot of activities. But what they have in common is that they're very limited in scope. For example, ECTP is very much EU projects focused, but without anything else other than that main focus. EAPPM, EGAIS, and so on. The common thing there is an annual conference, an annual meeting, but without the technical committees and the kinds of activities that can produce the policy papers, the position papers, and the other kinds of work, and so on. There's also some industry-oriented organizations, but they're very much on the industry side with little to no academic participation. I had some extra slides here, which I can see are not here. So that means your version is different than mine. Anyway, we missed some slides in the meantime. But anyway, I'll pass it on to you to continue here.
To the Wednesday?
Sure.
Just talk about it.
I mean, what we're proposing, yeah.
Okay. I'd like to add one or 2 points maybe to what you just said.
Yes, sir.
Part of the rationale, I think personally, when I see, look at this, I think the groups of the groups, the very first table you had, as you said, I think they're great initiatives and I think it should happen. But somehow it's difficult to maintain the momentum, and I think this is what I'm talking about. In contrast, the European academics, as opposed to the European civil engineering associations, are much more connected. We are collaborating a lot more, possibly through the European project, but actually through other mechanisms. And so we actually could be the glue that enables these European civil engineering organizations to collaborate more effectively. So I think that's very much what it's an important point that we can make. When it comes to the structure, well, if you're asking to do that, they've actually been part of the computing division. But the idea here, and I'll pass back to him, is to maybe try to replicate quite a bit the way they are structured, which is similar.
I mean, just to say something before we go to the details, in terms of understanding whether we can do something like this first, we looked at existing communities like ASC's computing division, which has been around for 30 years, has gone through the growing up process, through trial and error, has changed the structure multiple times, until it reached a sustainable model. And I'm trying to look in similar ways and see, well, what would be the equivalent in the EU spectrum? And so the equivalent actually would be the having as a parent some of the national organizations that are effectively equivalent to ASC. For example, in the UK, we have the Institution of Civil Engineers. And one of the things I try to do is go straight and talk to them and find out what they are interested in a community of this nature. There was actually quite a lot of interest, and exactly because of this interest, two representatives from the Institution of Civil Engineers are with us today, right here. And so I'd like you guys to give your perspective on the discussions we've had before I go on to details.
Thank you, credit for writing the decision centers. When the answer to this is initially about it, the needed interest for this. Perhaps one of the self-interest on the point to be about an institution, but I would say that that could be self-promoted by other institutions like ours in other countries, is that you need to talk about something that broadens your scope of influence, broadens your community outside of just your work. And what you said earlier is that in that game of love, there are more bridges to easy explore those. So the idea of a research day, and therefore a research focus, it's an institutional initiative, may already have one step up on the ladder for one business that has a lot of other types of food, perhaps trade bodies, which groups, and like that. So that's one thing that's like that.
I wasn't present in these positions that Hans had with Brennan and our director general as well, but from what I see on these very first slides, I see there's always been a good connection between academia and industry, and I think that similar to other institutions in other countries, if we actually move forward with having a meaningful in this initiative, I think that this is one of the key issue that will be, on our perspective, an important one. So high level research and forum and discussion fitting in to practice, industry, etc. So that's my initial thought.
I guess I was the other person in that meeting, and my understanding from what I heard from the director general is, we're not interested in your conferences. That's your own thing. You guys go and do it. What we are interested in is, how do we improve the profession? And the way that you guys can deliver that is through technical work, policy papers, position papers, grant challenge reports, the things I was mentioning before, bringing that into practice. The same way as ASC within its computing division, and through committees like DSA, data sensing and analysis, visualization, information modeling, and simulation, is able to create these kinds of reports and publish them through ASC and bring them out to the community. So, we're going off script.
Yeah, we'll get back to the focus after. Another is, I mean, at least from the UK's perspective, this has been very high up the agenda, but I know it's shared with other people across Europe. Right now, our research is not only a sense of how many papers are published and how many citations you get. More and more, the impact agenda is very high up. We are trying to find ways to generate this impact. If we can coordinate better with institutions that are actually in need of those reports, we can generate those reports on the back of our research projects, and that can justify better impact. So I think there's a great win-win situation in that sense, that it's not just about, yeah, almost, just not about creating connections to do the research, but also to disseminate the outcome of the research in various ways. And I mean, for us in the UK, this is becoming massively important. So we would do that anyways with the IC, but I think if we can actually all benefit from disseminating, just not in our national countries, but actually at least at a European level, not wider, that would be great.
Yeah, if we're already going on scope, then I'll add to that motivation. And I think that part of what we see as some of the benefits that both academia and industry, or you might add, if you think of the industry as design, AEC, and construction is, well, it's both industry, of course, but it's slightly different camps within the industry, and different needs and different requirements. So what can those three groups, academia, professions, and construction companies, let's say, benefit one from the other? If I look at it as an individual academic, then what I would like to get out of such a community is feedback. I'd like to expose my research to that community, but I'd also like to expose the industry onto professions at a level that goes beyond our journals and beyond our conferences, to have a much broader audience as using the associations as a sign up and a place to publish in the world, but also to get feedback about what are the major trends. And I think that a community of this kind within Europe could take a role in setting the agenda. Collaboratively, but in setting agenda and supporting. So when you talk about return on investment, justification, and so on, when we're talking about thrusts for research that could be spelled out in position papers and white papers, that could then be there to influence policy, whether it be in Horizon 2020, framework programs and so on for EU for funding for research, or whether it would influence construction companies to be able to gather around a common core or a common mechanism to then fund research through this community to different researchers. And I think those are the things that we stand to benefit. I think having heard you in our meetings and in the emails and sent to me, you describe the kind of benefits that US and Canadian and other researchers get from the construction institute on the one hand, and the computing division on the other hand, as a similar group. Encouragement, a channeling of funding, not directly, it's channeling, setting policies, setting priorities, setting grand challenge and goals for young researchers. Then I think those are very valuable things that we can do.
One more thing, interested to stay on script. Aside from the institution of civil engineers, we've already had just a very brief opportunity to talk to other colleagues, of course, not just from the UK, but from other countries, and see whether there's interest from other associations as well. And so what I'll do now is I'll very briefly pass the microphone to those colleagues who can report about the conversations they had with the ASE equivalent within their institutions. I'll start from Fred, who's been talking to the
colleagues. It's very unusual that RICS is another organization. It's UK based, but it's really international. And very close to getting interested in this point, this initiative. And then I will pass on to who else?
I'm going to put it on the front of the line. It's good to send an email and go over. Anybody else? So, if you want to.
Okay, I'm not that discussed with the case association to interface part of the
introduction.
Only said from the 3 months, professor at all the university. So I'm sure that this association of single university will be really interested in this stuff. Whereas I'm not that discussed with the university. This is the first part of my see this, but I'm really happy with this goes forward.
Thank you. And now also, Jakub
is here. Go to the back of the past that way. And then Peter is next to me.
Yes, I can talk to the last there's a suspension of this facility. And on the other hand, we should actually make sure that at the last time. A lot of these together and see where this could be such structures for development. Ultimately, members need to set goals, to set home goals, to kind of be a limitless programs and these things are not just it's another one that probably possible.
Can you pass it here?
Yes. I visited all this browser, so I asked also to the GPUs in my browser. The browser is a little better, it's not touchy, especially compared to the ASCP in the United States. But I think there's questions as well. I also with the browser. When you're in most of your history looking at my personal experience, you're looking at France and Germany and Italy, and you try to go on because these are behind in my countries and these are new strategies. So I think there's a need to stay there and France looking at that is there to actually put this up there. And yeah, I'm happy to support it.
Simon?
Yeah, just about the list the other organizations, also the technical chamber of Cyprus. I spoke to them a couple of months last week. They're very interested in the society. The rolling system is basically financial concern, but people address that a lot. They are very interested in
thank you. Partner?
I apologize from out of the university, I'm sorry, but we didn't get a chance to see Brian on this, but I did have a discussion with Ryan, and their response was quite positive. So they basically saw this as a strategic initiative and that they already have activities in this area, and they would like to join the give some comments, and I think we can discuss them, but the response was quite positive. Yes.
Hello, my name is Ina Shah. I'm from the University and I'm also a member of the Israel Association of Infrastructure and Civil Engineers. We are interested in participating in this group, computing in general and being in particular. of this building to actually contribute and participate.
Thank you very much. So as you can see, there is already some initial interest. Of course, nothing's been specifically defined in great detail. So everyone is saying, well, let's see what's coming next. Is there more into this? And you know, how much interest will there be? So what I'll try to do is I'll try to walk you through a possible scenario. It's not the only scenario. Just to help excite your imagination, okay? For those of you who are familiar with ASC's computer division, you'll find it very familiar. For the rest of you, it'd be an interesting example. And what I'd like for you to do is try to think, is this something that I see value in? Is this something that I would be interested to be a member of, to volunteer and participate in activities, obviously above and beyond a typical conference? And again, this is the whole point here. We're not trying to create just another conference. We have so many of those already. The entire scope of this conference was to bring many of them together, right? To increase the value of all of them. So we are by no means trying to push forward another one of the many conferences that already exist. This is more about the society that's behind it and very little about the meeting that the society is actually going to have. So, going back to script. We try not to reinvent the wheel. We try to look at an existing example, ASC's computing division, who's had the opportunity to go through all the failures over the past 30 years. And they've had quite a lot, no offense. I remember I was talking today with Carlos when we both joined the computing division. We went to committee meetings and there were three people in there. Luckily, they resolved those issues. And Carlos was telling me that now you go to those same meetings and there are 80 people in there. Okay? Quite a lot more interest. So how does that successful structure look like? Well, clearly, you start as an executive committee with rotating members, who is governing the overall community, and is supported by two representatives from ASC. What would be the equivalent in our case? Well, something similar, only instead of ASC being one organization, now we have representatives from all the various countries and their associations into the board. Moving further down, how is this community financed? Carlos, you said ASC gives 20,000 a year, is that right? Which roughly covers the costs of getting the representatives there, as well as the cost of the board members. Mostly, we're proposing something similar, that these institutions would then pay for their representative to come here, plus one extra person. And any leftover cost would be able to be assigned to projects. And also that the community can lightly tax its members through a conference fee to pay for student travel, scholarships, and other opportunities of this nature. It's going to have a legal and a financial structure. It will have to be registered as a nonprofit, have a treasurer, pretty much like every society out there, including ISARC and many other societies of this nature. Moving on to the more interesting things. Of course, it's going to have some administrative committees having things like rewards and publications, but the more interesting bit is the technical committees. The technical committees for sensing, for data analysis, for modeling, for standards. And another interesting thing I've discussed with IC, the human data interaction. How do we bring that social aspect into the data and the human factors into this process? And of course, education. There's more detail here of how these kinds of committees would work. These are just details, and of course, can change. And I would like not to focus this meeting today on these kinds of details because they're largely irrelevant when it comes to the broader scope. But rest assured that the main point here is to show that we are replicating an existing structure, trying to use that as a best practice, and trying to build on top of it to do additional work on top of everything else. You can see here information about committee meetings. We'll be happy, by the way, to share the slides with you, so you can take a look at this copy
video.
Actually, I don't need to share the slides with you. You have the video that you can play afterwards on YouTube and share with other people. Awards. I picked up some important names in our community here, just as an example. This is the kinds of things that ASE does quite a lot. And so, again, it'd be interesting to have these kinds of awards also for our community. For publications, of course, there is always a scope for publishing through journals. But having a publications committee can also be very useful when focusing on other forms of publications, such as, like I mentioned, the position papers, the white papers, and so on. And also articles in magazines of the parent institutions. And of course, not necessarily to do that themselves, but to organize task groups and individuals who would be interested to write these kinds of documents for these organizations. I'd rather take a break, actually. I'll pass the baton.
Well, in that case, you will want to comments and opinions.
Let's have a discussion.
Yeah, from the interview about whether this would make any sense to you, whether it would actually be relevant or not. And yeah, thank you.
Okay. This is a well-designed top-down structure. I'm really closer to, take a look at the ASCA. For such an association to get alive, I think it would also be good to start some bottom-up activities to push this life up. And on this, I would suggest right now is education or multiple before that. Enough expertise and knowledge in such informatics to be able to cover your very, very specific topics. Actually, this idea was already suggested some 70 years ago. ITC construction must program was born and is not right, but it's just doing one master program. Because they are the choice master program is still. During that time, another idea emerged and started to somehow grow that definitely needs that first goal, and it is about the joint course school.
Thank you, Dan. So that brings to mind two things. One thing is on the education front, AAC does an excellent job through its Global Center and Education Committee preparing new modules that the entire community can share. This way we can help standardize and improve all of our classes in BIM and other topics. So that's one great value that this kind of activity can bring. The other thing you're coming to mind would be something that Reimer Sherry told me yesterday, Reimer's right over there, about how timely this is. And his comment was very good. Back when he started the ECPBM, when maybe Reimer was to say something on that, in those days, there just wasn't critical mass, there just wasn't you know, this number of people are able to support a community of this nature. But fortunately, times are changing. So Zoom in a few decades later, now we have hopefully enough people that can support something of this nature. But go ahead.
Yeah. I have two different contributions. Starting with the government, that we make this effort already 20 years or at least it's 94 or something. And I strongly support the game starts this effort. And you know the possibility of success is higher, but we are still involved in this. But there's no first place to have a year conference. We already 94 did it up to 2 initiatives. And this was the surviving was 2 conferences. One is the BPM, which was not started as a conference. The idea was exactly an association. Yeah, the conference was only a meeting point. It should be not too often, yes, because it was designed 2 years. At the end, and it was starting with industry day. So the conference was 2 days. Papers and one of the industry contributors. And the others are about that the industry investors are so much a part of the academic papers that the industry was interest. Okay, so it was coming up to an academic conference. So this was the one. The other conference was created by Swiss, which showed it also as a workshop. And this is every year, this was called European Corp of artificial intelligence or like that, you know, it was in construction. And the third initiative was exactly about this master course in 2000. It was a CFP conference in Iceland where the idea was born and the money was coming from Erasmus, which I was also a member, but I was a lazy member because it was not written in my curriculum. Was the English language, and we had to learn from the German language, the lectures. Okay, and this is one of the problems here in European languages. Okay, in my view, in this direction is picking up these initiatives because they are there, they are not conflicting, and you see it in your program, and your conference, or maybe one is the ECPM, one year, the other year is the this as a European group after a conclusion. This is one possibility, and the other is how how many things in life? Because it was the same initiatives that we did by Francis and I, but we never integrated in the big construction industry. When we started this stuff, we were not supported by our national associations because we are founding a new association. I was thinking what is existing. So yesterday I saw this is the European Association of the Construction Industry, which is very well organized and it has a headquarter in Brussels and they have good relations to their community. I learned they are working in the people and very and my little part was accepted by the European Commission, maybe in that field was already. So this was one possibility. The other, and we saw now a strong affiliation of single engineers in Europe, and also in Europe, former world, in Europe, construction in Novartis, I was in construction engineering, and there is strong votes, but there are not associations that are working for the European codes. So we have a strong group of working together of all the European countries in wood, in steel, in the most community. And another group is working on the business. And these are European codes. But the European codes are still not conformed to national codes. Here and there, yes, but mostly not. This is Europe. But this group are strong. This is a possibility to get a basic to make this idea alive.
That's very nice. Thank you, Ryan. There's a comment here.
And my comment.
I'm seeing is a student ignorance, or I like the knowledge of it. We started having this discussion about how this could potentially look like. Of course, as you said, it's only one scenario, it's not the only scenario, the only scenario. But is there a clearly defined scope and vision? Because that would mostly like make clarity in defining how this could potentially look like, the level of involvement of organizations, like I see in others. So I don't know if this has already been discussed in within other parts of this conference, or if this is the first time that we're discussing this subject matter now. So I would really like to have your view on that. And sorry, the second point is I think there's a member there discussing about the open approach, which in our experience when it comes to content and knowledge sharing tends to work best rather than organization media, you can have a top down approach or better, allocate resources and board, etc. But I'm very much in favor of the bottom up approach in terms of content creation and collation and then dissemination tends to work much better in that. It offers much more agility and flexibility, if you will, towards the overall strategic aim that the organization can.
So for your first question, we have defined a possible vision and path forward, which is referenced in the slides, and we'll share with everyone. But we cannot say that this is the definitive one, exactly because that's why we're having the meeting today. Present to everyone, get their views, and perhaps after this meeting, this can change completely. And so that's the point here. This is a possible solution, but not necessarily the solution. And this is why we like the feedback. For the second bit, clearly, without participation, none of this would work. Okay? And so the real thing we're asking for here, and the most critical one, is not the edges around the details of how this is going to run or the other things are going to run, but mostly, are people interested? Do they see value? Is this something that would help their careers if they had an avenue to publish policy work through ICE and the corresponding through Cyprus, through Germany, France, and so on and so on. And all the other things that are discussed in this presentation, do they see value in that? And if they do, how much are they willing to commit of themselves for their time? Because again, all these organizations are volunteer organizations. And without these volunteers, they wouldn't be able to go. So my short answer is I'll tell you afterwards.
Thank you.
Have any comments?
Yeah. That's one of the reasons in Germany. Also, I'm not part of any of the committees, and I see all of these conferences. I spent part of my life in the United States with ACE, and I think they had a good set in the first language, was mentioned earlier. We hang on each other, and that's for our value. So I think the committees, ACS, don't have that much impact on the individual, at least when I go back at my career in the United States. So I would question, what do you really want to contribute as a benefit for the individual? Second, I think it's very important for Europe to set up the plate and create something that is representing us here in Europe, because I think we do a great job in each one of the communities. And I learned that last week when I saw you in Taipei, where industry representatives came to me in the printing and said, well, we have such a great name, ISAR. The European community has been the same. It's just about branding, coming up with a brand, a name that represents everyone. And that would be what I respect, you do a fantastic job in research. I would be as rigorous as possible in trying to possibly disrupt what we currently do in terms of saying we have all of these little conferences. Why cannot we agree and team up and creating this one conference? It doesn't have to be big and small, many locations, whatever format it has, but representing everybody, building one brand name, tackling multiple problems like education, etc. If you get that done, you have a successful community for Europe, and that's exactly what you have to do. And I like the talk earlier about that. If you get that forward. I think that's exactly what you need, especially to get the interview, get the industry to contribute and talk about impact trend. I think it's very, very critical. And industries out there, like a lot of other industry companies, they have no clue what construction they can have in some of them. And there are big corporations in the world, and they are desperate for solutions. So just team up, create a brand name, and it's not so much about the committees, like executive committees, sorry to say that, and meeting and traveling and going here and there, it's just about doing.
Yes,
but I need to organize, that's why it's super important.
And I just have a very brief comment on the difference. Talking about running this and better than 1,000% quicker the branding issue. And I think it wasn't further than not necessarily one conference, but quite a bit. We could potentially explore an umbrella of conferences under branding. That's a big thing. That would also be an idea.
Yeah, actually, that's an important point. A lot of the European communities, by virtue of being national and as a consequence, relatively small, there's always this natural insecurity that, you know, I have already so few people. What happens if I start going to other conferences? And I lose my community identity and I may disappear and so on. And I think that's the wrong approach. The right approach is the opposite. It's what we're doing in this conference. And the reason, by the way, we're having this meeting in this conference is because this conference is kind of an example of how we would like this community to run. Bring everyone together, join our forces with everybody else, and largely create the kind of an environment that people would want to attend. So that we don't have to worry about, oh, I have, you know, 30 or 40 people, and if I lose another 10, I'm in danger of disappearing.
Yeah, I just like to support, I think the other unit to be on that. And then in the sense of creating community, and that requires a minimum amount of weight. One of the ideas that we've talked about is that, of course, any conference we would do would be once every second year to match even along with the international competitors in the similar year, which is the CBE conference, which is exactly what the ASCE do. So then on, I don't know, of course, it's even on here, but there would be an ASCE continuing conference in the US and an EC3 continuing constructing conference in Europe, and the fifth year we will meet an international meeting. And if we were able to form the umbrella where ECPPM and NIS and other groups, which certainly W78 is coming out, which are international groups, but certainly the European ones would be comfortable to either co-locate in parallel or in consecutive their conferences. I think the government would be very happy to see that.
I'm fine, you want to go first?
Microphone?
He's not.
I don't think I'm not asking for the discussions. How is it about the creation of the industry? This is a big impact at the moment because of the big impact. Governments are pushing forward. It's not really that statement was now coming up here. And it can depend on the big infrastructure, or the public infrastructure project must be done here. Nobody knows what is still in the university at the time, and this was a big impact in the world. Who can educate our workers in the world? So this was bringing all the other courses from any education institution, private education institution, and we are starting to regulate and communicate the guidelines regarding our association of engineers. This is a lot of regulations. These are worldwide accepted, for instance, the ISO quality management 9000 was coming from the German Association of Professionals. So we have to have a group of ideas in the group of qualification. We have regulation for all these aspects. But qualification is how, who is qualified to apply for a job. What are the different qualification levels which are given to institutions, and the institutions can make seminars. So the seminars are very interesting. But you are in competition then. And the other competition is exactly building smart is going to be said. And building smart is where I think more powerful in Europe than other countries because they take the role partially what you want to do. They bring people together and construction informatics. And they then already developing of curriculums for giving qualification for several countries and then going to harmonize them on the international level. So I think we should contact or demonstrate this being smart because this is a key entry point in the industry.
Thank you, Raimon. Actually, I had the CEO of BuildingSmart, Rachel Petri, in my office 2 weeks ago. And we had a long discussion about this. There's clearly quite a lot of interest from BuildingSmart into this community. Obviously, their focus is a lot more narrow. They're focusing on a very, very specific thing. But at the same time, what they're proposing can cover a lot of other things that they are very interested in. So Richard really wants to see how this evolves, and we'll try to make sure that we keep coordinating with them. Carlos, you want to say a few things from the ASC's perspective?
Okay, let's now start with the professor, Mr. Patsy Austin, as chair of the executive committee of the community division of ASC. Just following up on some of the discussions that a couple of things of impact that the community division had and it's having in research and education. And we talked not only the research side, but also at the education component. One thing that it helped create in the U.S., consider that we have 52 states and some universities that are all like top tier research and others, and more scholars that are more teaching schools. But the fact that we had a group that promoted initiatives in different levels and looking at different focus areas construction. It really helped also to disseminate knowledge of construction and computing applications for construction and civil engineering across the board with many more institutions that you used to have, I would say, 5 years ago. And another thing that helped, and in fact, what Ian has mentioned in the beginning, when we first got started in division about 15, 20 years ago, it was a smaller group, a lot of more senior faculty that were retiring and younger generation. And it took a while to rebuild some of that community. I remember the first few workshops that we organized 15 years ago, we described 70 participants. Last week we had the national shopping business in the and the event was sold out, so they had to close registration because we reached the 260 participants. And I was really pleased about when I went to some of the meetings of the super leaders, and they were almost packed and a lot of energy, especially from the young generation. People that were coming from different institutions to participate. And not only from the US and Canada, we had a lot of participants, especially from Asia, each helped network in the US and share their work.
Thank you, Carlos. One last thing because we need to wrap up for those who need to catch on to the tour. Can we please do a show of hands? Who's interested in this? Who would like to hear more about this in the future?
Thank you for your hand.
All right. Thank you very much. That sounds very promising. Thank you for coming to this meeting. We will take on this feedback, try to make some adjustments, and then Rafael will share with everyone some questions to help collect additional feedback, as well as to find out who's willing to volunteer for this and invest some of their time in subsequent stages.
Anything else?
No.